Hey everyone, just quick announcement before I share today's episode with Karen Burzichelli. Karen is doing some amazing work and I'm excited for her to get to share her story. But just want to take a minute to share the release of my first children's book of my healthy children's book series called Maddox's Trip to the Chiropractor. It's a cute book with bright pictures that follows a toddler on her trip to the chiropractor. It shows her excitement and how she knows that it impacts her health in a positive way. And each purchase of the book will be supporting a project that I started called the Unlock Wellness Project. For each purchase of the book, we will be donating a wellness bag to a child in need. These wellness bags will include non-toxic, chemical-free essentials such as soap, shampoo, toothpaste, a toothbrush, items that a lot of the time children in tough situations don't have access to. You can learn more about the book and about the Unlock Wellness Project by going to drkaseyjohnson.com, that's drkaseyjohnson.com, click on the shop tab, then click the children's book option. You'll be able to read a short description and even watch a short video with more information. You can also purchase the book directly on amazon.com by searching Maddox's Trip to the Chiropractor. But I hope you guys love the book. Be sure to check out my website to learn more, and thank you so much for the support. Now it's time for today's episode. I hope you love my conversation with Karen Burzichelli. Welcome to the Unlock Wellness Podcast. I'm Dr. Casey and excited for today's guest. I'm here with Karen Burzichelli, and Karen is a registered nurse and an integrative nutrition health coach. And after Karen dealt with digestive issues for 25 years, as well as low energy, weight gain, arthritis, and skin issues, she knew that she needed to make a change. So after discovering a whole food plant-based diet, her life drastically transformed for the better. So I'm just excited for Karen to share her story and just everything that she's working on. So Karen, thank you so much for coming on. I'm excited to have you.
Oh, thank you so much for having me. I really appreciate it.
Yeah. So, you know, let's just jump into your backstory, you know, just kind of walk us through, just your health journey, really, you know, what it looked like at a young age and just how it kind of progressed over time and what really led you to want to make such a drastic change.
I was always a skinny kid. I was that, you know, that friend that was, could eat anything she wanted and never gained any weight and everybody hated it. But I wasn't a good eater. I was a junk food eater. And my background is Italian. My mother's first generation, my dad's like half a first generation. So, you know, they grew up with eating, you know, whole foods and from the garden and everything. But my mother hated to cook, which is really weird. And she got married at a very old age. She was 30 when she got married. So, that was the year, you know, 1960 is when all the convenient foods came out. So I think, you know, my mother hated to cook so much. She just started, you know, buying all these convenient foods. So we really grew up with a lot of packaged stuff, canned vegetables and, you know, like instant mashed potatoes, TV dinners, all that stuff.
You know, Karen, you know, we kind of take that for granted. Like I was, you know, it's kind of funny. Like you were talking about like that start of like that instant food. You know, I'm sure that was an interesting time because if you were somebody that didn't like to cook and at that time there's no research to tell you it's bad and then you had like this microwave and instant food, like, I mean, that probably sounds like amazing at that time. So you can't blame them, but I mean, I'm sure that was just super interesting time with all of that.
Well, it is. And it was really, I mean, like growing again, like I was also the skinny one and everybody in my family was always on a diet. Like my mom wasn't really overweight. She always carried like maybe 20 extra pounds. She's short. She's only 5 foot, but my brother and my dad were always overweight. So everybody was always on a diet. Like we always had like diet margarine and all this stuff and, you know, diet stuff in the house that I really didn't eat because I didn't really need to be on a diet, but I ate a lot of junk. Mm-hmm. So I really didn't learn a lot of home cooking. I mean, we did some, you know, from scratch and I loved to bake. I actually won the award in eighth grade for home economics because I loved to bake so much and I used to decorate cakes and do all this stuff.
That's cool.
You know, I even going into college, I never really gained that freshman 15. I never really had to diet. So I never had a food issue. But once I once I got pregnant with my twins, who are now 29, I think that's really when all my issues started, because I had severe hyperemesis, which is, you know, just vomiting excessively for up until about 12, 13 weeks of my pregnancy. And I'm 5'4", and I was, you know, 3.5 months pregnant, and I weighed 106 pounds.
Wow.
With twins.
That's crazy.
Yeah. So I was really sick, and I probably set me up for a lot of, you know, issues, digestive issues, just from probably the throwing up in my esophagus and everything. And then when they started growing, I made it to 37, almost 38 weeks, which is a lot for twins. They were both breached. So I had two heads, you know, way up and pressing on my esophagus and pushing up. So I dealt with such severe, upper gastric pain, mm-hmm. and reflux. My last probably month of pregnancy, if I hadn't been a nurse, I probably would have been in the ER every other day, because I knew it was heartburn, but it felt like I was having a heart attack. The pain was so bad. So really that was my journey. I just started with I had my first endoscope at, you know, I think I was 27. I just started having a lot of GI problems. And then I had complications from my C-section. I ended up having to get reopened up at 10 days post-op.
Wow.
Because I was bleeding internally. So I ended up with a lot of adhesions on my bowels and everything. So it was just a nightmare.
Not to mention probably the medications that they probably had to give you, or the antibiotics. And you're just crushing the, you know, digestive system just left and right.
Exactly. Of course, now we know all this. And the other thing that they did, which they did what they called back then, was an incidental appendectomy, which means they took out my appendix. There was nothing wrong with it, but they figured they were in there, they'll just take it out. And this is something they did, you know, 29 years ago. So, but now we know that, you know, that the appendix has something to do with your digestive system. I'm like, God wouldn't make something that didn't really have a function. So,
exactly.
So that was my, you know, my setup. And this was, you know, I was 26 at the time. So I just, you know, struggled throughout the years, you know, diagnosed with IBS, reflux. Those were my two severe problems. And then once I hit 50, which will be almost 6 years ago in January, I really hit a low point in my life. I had gone to my GYN annual visit, and I had gained 10 pounds from the previous year, and which is 20 pounds above my natural weight. I was okay with the 10 extra weight, but that extra 10 pound just kind of put me over. You know, when you're someone just, you're used to being thin all your life, that extra weight now was really, I was very self-conscious of it. And if you asked any of my friends, nobody would have ever said I was overweight, because I was always the thin one. Even when I was 20 pounds heavier, I was still thinner than all my friends.
Right. So to them, it probably looked normal. But I mean, obviously, yeah, like you were saying, if you've grown up thin, like you notice it, and plus you're feeling the difference. Like I know that you had some energy issues and things like that. Like you're feeling that internally as well.
Yeah. So it just, it just escalated. And I was at this point now, I had been diagnosed with arthritis in both my knees. And I also had a herniated disc in my back that I was diagnosed with. I had really bad skin issues that I would break out really bad on my hands. And I contributed to working as a nurse with, you know, washing my hands a million times a day. Mm-hmm. And I also had chronic chapped lips, insomnia, hot flashes, couldn't sleep. Had really low energy. And I am a labor and delivery nurse. So I work 12-hour shifts, and we do close to 6,000 deliveries at the hospital I work at a year. So we're quite busy. So it's nonstop. It's pretty nonstop. And it's a physical job. I mean, you know, you remember when you had your baby, you know, if you remember your nurse, I mean, there's a lot of, you know, equipment that we have to move. We got to break the bed, you know, we got to move patients and, you know, it's very physical. So
plus the stress, because I mean, that's a very important job, and like a very, you know, the most important day of, I mean, these women's lives, like that's a lot on you as well.
Yeah, it was. And personally, I didn't have a lot of stress because I know my job, I do my job really well, and it's mm-hmm. really a great place to work. I mean, you know, there are stressful situations where we do have things that go wrong, but for the majority part, it is a happy place to work. So stress really wasn't that big of a deal. I didn't have a lot of stress in my life. My kids were grown at this point. They were out of the house and on their own. And, you know, me and my husband were doing fine. So stress, it wasn't, it was just a physical that I had so many issues with.
Gotcha.
And I actually was contemplating quitting my job because I would actually cry at the end of the shift because my knees hurt me so bad. And I had done two rounds of shots in my knees for the arthritis, but they really didn't help. They were kind of just a Band-Aid, mm-hmm. A temporary fix. So here I am. It should be a great time in my life. You know, we're empty nesters. We have financial freedom. We can travel. And I felt terrible. And I just said to my husband, I can't imagine living the rest of my life feeling like this. I have to do something. And I was always one to read, you know, I was used to take a lot of vitamins and some herbs and stuff. Well, finally, I know some people have, you know, their feelings about the Dr. Oz show, but there are some good doctors that do appear on there.
Right.
Some of our, you know, good plant-based doctors appear. So, I happened to be watching it one day and there was a doctor on there who specialized in food allergies and he talked about dairy and how you may not be the lactose that's bothering you, but the actual protein, the casein, that we're really not meant to eat dairy, blah, 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 you know. So, he said, try doing a dairy cleanse and, take some probiotics. They talked about the, you know, the leaky gut and how, you know, the gut is damaged. So that's what I did. I was eating Greek yogurt every day and I really didn't have a bad diet. I mean, you know, what I thought was bad, I would eat, you know, chicken, turkey, maybe some vegetables. And, mm-hmm. you know, I wasn't a big junk eater. So I tried doing that. And in the first week, I just stopped eating the yogurt every day and started taking a probiotic and I lost 5 pounds in 1 week. And the bloatiness started going down. And then I thought, wow, this is crazy. I need to like start researching more. So I just went full steam ahead, researched, and then watched, you know, Forks Over Knives, the classic. Chris Carr's book was my first book I read, Crazy Sexy cool. Diet.
Yep.
Love her. So I learned a lot of that. And I literally took a trash bag and threw everything out my house that was processed. My husband thought I was crazy. But I'm like, I got to do this. And then I started researching and then I eventually came probably between 6 and 9 months. I transitioned to a full food plant-based diet and lost 20 pounds without really even trying. No, not really exercising, doing a little bit of, you know, gentle exercising. Mm-hmm. And I was back down to my pre-pregnancy weight, you know, when I was 26 years old at the age of 50. And, you know, once you hit menopause, you know, which I was full blown into menopause, it's really hard to lose that weight. And if you look at everybody who's postmenopausal, they usually start gaining weight around their stomach, in that abdominal region. And we all know that's like, you know, the fat that's not good for us. So I was like thrilled. I could not believe it was just falling off of me. So being a nurse and being a type A personality, I thought, oh my God, I got to tell everybody about this. Like, like everybody needs to know about this. And people noticed me. I mean, especially at work. I mean, my energy level was like ridiculous now. Like I could now run circles around the nurses half my age. Like I couldn't believe how much energy I had. And I'd go home and I'd still have energy after working a 12.5-hour shift.
Yeah. And like what kind of, I mean, obviously, you know, your husband's seeing the changes that you're having, you know, probably, you know, your kids are too, whenever, you know, they're around, but like, how did that influence them? Like, did your husband jump on board too? Or did like your kids want to try it out as well?
Well, since my kids didn't live with me, it was kind of like, it took them a little bit more, but with my husband, he's a thin guy. So he's not heavy either, but he does take blood pressure medicine, which, you know, that's another issue. But anyway, he loves his junk food. He loves his cookies and everything. So I pretty much started buying like organic cookies and, you know, stuff that didn't have like high fructose corn syrup. And, you know, I read more labels. So eventually, and then I would like make like stir fry and then I would put chicken in his. And then eventually he would say to me, well, you don't have to put the chicken in mine. And he's like, you don't have to buy these cookies anymore. So I pretty much made it like, you know, him to be on board too, because we probably would have been divorced if I would have said, no, you're not eating any of this. I mean, he could have bought it himself, like, because I said, you can buy yourself, but
yeah.
He was actually pretty good. And even to this day now, like he's not completely plant-based, but he's plant-based in my house.
Right. You know, it's a super gradual process. And no, I totally agree, Karen. And it's like, you know, the same thing with like, you know, it's like my husband, he's not, he is not vegan, but for the most part, whenever, you know, we're eating dinner together, because we cook, I mean, almost every night, like he'll cook things that we can eat because he knows I'm not going to eat it. So like the amount of meat that he consumes now is so drastically less. But it's cool because like, it's just the progress, you know, it's just those small changes over time. And like, I've noticed it with him, even though it's just those small changes, but like, it's cool to watch.
Yeah. And I've noticed that because I, you know, with my personality and, you know, I think everybody I've talked to becomes plant-based and gets such great results, especially if they're in the medical community, you know, really want to, you know, tell everybody about it and be, mm-hmm. you know, want everybody to change, but you know, you can't do that. So when I decided to step back and, you know, let him do what he needs to do, he started making better choices on his own, because I'm like, I can't care. I just told him, I said, it's not fair for me to care more about your health than you to care about your health. So I have to let go of it. And, you know, you're going to have to want it. I can't want it for you. So he's made better choices by me just pretty much backing off. And with my kids, they just, every time they came home, you know, this is what I made. And we just started talking about it. And mm-hmm. they both suffered with acne their whole entire life, which is really weird because I never really suffered with it. But I really, growing up, I never really ate a lot of dairy because it did hurt my stomach. So I never ate a lot of ice cream and cheese and stuff. So, but with them, they did. And once I, you know, found out the connection with dairy, I said, you know, you need to just stop the dairy. Well, finally, after probably, I don't know how long it was, but they finally gave up dairy, but that was it. But they were eating more every time I came to, because they work in New York City. So every time we went to the city, we would go to another vegan restaurant and everything. So that was cool. And they eventually, they're actually both vegan now, and I'm just so super excited. I can't even stand it.
That's
but
cool. Yeah, I mean, all you can do yeah. is by example and love, and yeah, no, that's amazing that they've jumped on board too.
Right, exactly. So after I, you know, found all this information, I said I got to find a way to do this for a living too. So that's when I went to IIN, and even though they're not. I wasn't fully vegan when I went to them, but I was probably 90%. Mm-hmm. And, you know, the school was not, the nutrition part is not all plant-based. Well, I just should recall, it is all plant-based. It's not vegan, you know, because most whole food plant-based diets, I mean, like paleo and all them, they're really based on whole food plant-based. They're right. just not plant pure. So, you know, they emphasize, you know, no processed foods, you know, organic as much as possible. Obviously, they're like, if you're eating meat, eat grass fed, which, you know, really doesn't make, I think, a whole difference, but, and not a whole lot of it. But what I got from them was really learning how to deal more with people, even though I was a nurse and dealt with people. I really didn't deal with them on the sense that I needed to for a coaching matter. So it was really invaluable what the lessons that I learned here. Plus they helped me like with on the business end of it too, because I knew nothing about business.
Yeah. What do you think you learned most from them? Like you were saying, it helped you with communicating with your patients. Was it more, I'm just like getting on their, like that level playing field, just like seeing where they're coming from, like that kind of thing? Or like, how do you mean by that?
Yeah. Well, it really helped me. Like I can't even remember the name of the person that I, because we had so many lectures that we had to listen to, and there was just so many people in all different disciplines. And this one lecture that I listened to, and I still refer to it all the time, is she said, you have to stop caring about people. Like you have to stop caring about what they do, you know, the decisions they make. If it's not directly on you, then you have to stop, you know, you have to just let it go. And like I said, that helped me with my family, because like I said, when I was hounding my husband, it was just making me upset. He'd come home from work, I'd be like, what'd you eat for lunch today? You know, and then if he told me he went to Chick-fil-A, I'd be like, well, what'd you do that for? You know, and then I got upset. He didn't get upset. I got upset.
Right.
So I thought, so she was, you know, it was like, you know, you have to let go of that. And also just to meet people, they learned to, you know, meet people where they are, and also to teach people to crowd out, you know, to crowd out, not to eliminate anything, just to crowd it out. So, you know, instead of eating a piece of fish that's, you know, 6 inches big, you know, eat a 3-piece and put more vegetables on your plate. So just the communication part of it was very invaluable to me, and it really helped. And then the other thing I really learned from them, where he emphasized, was to start with your own in your own community. So that's what I did. I started inviting people to my house and cooking for them and having classes at my house and just teaching them how to read labels and, you know, buying better products. And eventually it went into whole food plant-based cooking lessons, where with even less processed food. Now everything I teach, I probably 5% of it is processed. Everything else is just whole foods.
That's cool.
And I just started reaching out to people. We had an organic farm that opened up down the street from me, and they had a kitchen in there. So I you know, said, can I teach classes in there? So I started teaching classes with them, and I just started reaching out to people in the area. Anybody I saw that was plant-based or vegan, I would just start reaching out to them and doing classes. And I would start teaching my patients. I would just start talking about it. You know, especially my patients who were sick, who were diabetic, who were overweight. You know, I started telling them my story, and then they'd be interested. And then I teach them some stuff, and I give them my card. And so that's basically how everything started. And then what it evolved into is doing some dinners where I started getting some plant-based doctors to come talk. And I reached out to some local restaurants and convinced them to let me do a dinner there, and gave them my recipes, and had worked with the chefs so they could cook a whole food plant-based dinner with no oil, which was really, you know, when you say to a chef, no oil, they're like, what?
How am I going to cook?
So the first one I did, I had 42 people show up, which I was like, I couldn't believe it. So then I approached another one, and I got 100 people to show up.
Wow.
And, you know, got more interest. And then I just asked like local people that I knew were plant-based. Like I have a friend, her and her husband are pharmacists who are now plant-based. So she talked about, you know, that with pills, you know, plants versus pills. And I have a nurse anesthetist friend who's plant-based, who works in a cardiac hospital. So she does a lot of cardiac surgery. So, you know, she talked about the aspects of diet with heart cardiac disease. And then a couple people give their testimonials who, you know, had some transformations. And then I brought in, I had Dr. Saray Stanzik.
Yes. Yeah.
You know, Saray, right? Yeah. Well, she's in New Jersey. So I reached out to her, and I had reached out to her previously because of her code blue. And we had been kept in touch, and we had met a few times, and I asked her if she would be interested in coming down. So she came down to a dinner, and I got about 85 people for that one. And and after every dinner, I have people who have gone plant-based. And after Saray's dinner, I've had about 6 people from that dinner that I know of that have reached out to me and are kept in contact and are having like amazing results. And
that's cool. Can you think of any like success stories right off that you were just extremely
proud? I have my one girlfriend, she saw me, and you know, she was like, what are you doing, Karen? And so I told her, and she's struggled with digestive issues her entire life. She was taking Miralax for 15 years. And she was 5 years older than me, so she was like 55 at the time, and had you know, colonoscopies, endoscopes, everything. And, you know, they no really true diagnosis, always dealt with constipation and everything. So I told her, I also got rid of gluten too for, when I initially stopped, changed my diet, which really helped too, I think with the inflammation, just till I got the inflammation down. Mm-hmm. So she stopped that, and she noticed a difference right away. And then she eventually went completely whole food, plant-based. And she just had her 5-year colonoscopy about 2 months ago, it was probably about 3 or 4 months ago. And, she didn't tell the doctor what she was doing. She just had her colonoscopy. And when she woke up, he said, your colon is absolutely normal. You do not have to come back for 10 years. She started crying because it had been 3.5 years. But she'd been plant-based, and she told him, you know, what
what she was doing. And he said, well, keep doing what you're doing because it's working. She said it was her first ever normal colonoscopy in her entire life.
Awesome.
And people don't recognize her because she looks, and that's the first thing people compliment you on when you go whole food, plant-based, is your skin. I mean, people ask me, what are you using your skin? I'm like, I eat plants. I mean, I use coconut oil on my skin. That's all I use. And I don't wear any wake up to work. And I wear very minimum when I do go out. I actually have less wrinkles now than I did 5 years ago.
That's awesome. Yeah, no, it's just so cool. I mean, I'm sure just how rewarding it is for you, because I mean, just like, you know, you think back, you know, 10 years ago, I mean, could you have ever imagined your life going this way and you're like teaching classes and like really making an impact, especially in your community? Like, it's just so incredible to hear just how big of a difference that you're making.
Well, and that's it. It's just, like you said, 10 years ago, if you would have told me I was going to be vegan, I'd be like, what are you, crazy? Like, nowhere. I mean, that had never, and it's really funny because I have a sister-in-law who is vegetarian, and she's been vegetarian since she was 17. And I was just talking to her about this over Thanksgiving, because she is now vegan because of me. But we never talked about it. Like, she never talked about it to me. Like, and I just thought, oh, okay, oh, Jeanette's a vegetarian. She don't eat meat, you know. But I never thought about it. But now I've become so passionate about, like, the animals part of it that, you know, I sit there. I said, I wonder if you had even talked to me if it would have sunk in. I don't know. Obviously, you know, hindsight is 20/20. But, you know, now I can't even imagine eating an animal because I just have such a visceral effect, you know, from it. And I'm sitting here petting my dog. I'm like, there's no difference between my dog and a pig, you know, or a cow or a chicken. So, and I just had a client leave right before you called that I went grocery shopping for. And,
awesome.
Who's a friend of mine and trying to help her. She's got fatty liver and she's really like now serious. And, her son is pretty much vegan too now. And I said, he's working at a farm thing. And I'm like, I have that connection now. And she's like, yeah, yeah. But it's amazing just in my community, how many people, the ripple effect has just been, I mean, I could be here for hours and tell you stories of the ripple effect.
Oh,
how
I'm
many
sure.
People.
I'm sure. And I could listen to all of them too.
Yeah. And
no,
it just makes
it's just so awesome.
Yeah. And it makes me, every time someone sends me an email, I cry.
Yeah. I mean, yeah. Cause I mean, that's life changing. It doesn't matter what age that person is at, like that drastically will change their life, their family's life, how they raise their kids or like, you know, influence their grandkids even. So like, you just don't know how far reaching that it'll be. So, yeah, I mean, I would cry too.
Yeah. And now, like I say, my girls are finally both, my one daughter would be a year this month. And what made her go vegan was I actually took her to the New York screening of Eating You Alive. Mm-hmm. It was right before Christmas and she came out of the movie and she's like, okay, mom, I'm really seriously going to try to do this. I said, okay. And she went to Cuba over Christmas break. And she said the first meal they had, there was a chicken and it still had feathers on it.
Oh,
so she said, that's it. She was done. Rice and beans for her the whole time she was there. It took my other daughter, actually just until probably June. All she was eating was a little bit of turkey and chicken. Mm-hmm. And finally, she just decided she was giving it up, and she did. And again, they both struggled with skin issues, and they got better with no dairy, but it still never completely cleared up. And she struggled more, and she'd been going to an esthetician for a couple years now. And right after she gave up the meat completely, she went back to her esthetician, and her skin was completely clear, and she couldn't.
That's awesome.
She couldn't believe it. She's like, what are you doing? She goes, I stopped eating meat. So you know, and the fact that they don't have children yet, but I know now that when they do have children, I'm not going to be the crazy grandma.
Right. Right.
Right.
Yeah, no, for sure. And like, yeah. And I mean, as far as, I mean, think about how better their pregnancy will be as well.
Just because
of that fact alone. Like, you know, I personally, like I wasn't vegan yet during the pregnancy, but I did 2 months afterwards because I was having like mastitis issues and things like that. And it was, oh man, but it helped. I mean, drastically got rid of that. But I mean, even like we were talking about the, you know, getting back to pre-pregnancy weight. Once I did that, I mean, I got back to that in less than, just without working out like you were. I mean, very similar. It's just very cool. And I mean, and I know that's very appealing to new moms, just the weight alone, but I mean, obviously the other health benefits as well, but it's just really amazing to see how it can literally affect any health issue going on, whether it's weight, or maybe you don't have a weight issue, like, you know, your husband didn't have a weight issue, but you just don't know what's happening on the inside. Like, it's not all about the physical, but there's no negatives that are going to happen by implementing it.
No. And I had a patient the other day that, I was like palpating her uterus. And I was like, whoa, I said, you have a fibroid, don't you? She goes, yeah, I got several. And I said, well, you know what will help help with your fibroids? And she's like, what? I said, a vegan diet. And she was like,
yeah.
She goes, you know, she goes, I have friends that are vegan. She goes, and I have read that. So it's like, and I'm very, like I said, I joke around and everything and I get to know the patient. So, so then I tell my story and I'm like, really? I said, you really, plus she was overweight too, like way overweight. And so, you know, I just plant the seed and I'm like, I'm here, I can help you. But you really, I said, and I, you know, I give them kind of like a little guilt going, like, you know, you're a mom now, you have a baby to take care of, you got to take care of yourself. Right. So I use every opportunity I can to teach. I love to teach. I'm also a childbirth educator. So, I'm hoping I'm actually going to work with someone. We're going to do putting together a program for a pregnancy, like a relaxation, breathing, nutrition class.
That's cool.
And the girl that's going to do like a yoga meditation. She's plant-based and she just had a baby. She was completely plant-based during her pregnancy. And, she looks wonderful. She had a beautiful pregnancy, beautiful delivery. Baby's perfect. So, you know, I need somebody who's actually lived it to be a partner with me. So I'm working on that now. And I'm also working on, I have another, food as medicine seminar coming up in January where I've reached out. We've got our local doctors. I have a plant-based cardiologist here who actually is, Dr. Letterman. Are you familiar with Dr. Matthew Letterman?
Oh, you know, I'm not, but I'll write down his name and check him out.
Yeah. Well, he's the doctor that was in Forks Over Knives.
Oh,
him and
okay.
his wife. Gotcha. Him and his wife. They're out in California. And he just wrote a book with, John Mackey, The Whole Diet, I think it's called. Well, anyway, it's his father. He's a cardiologist here right in New Jersey.
That's really awesome.
Yeah. So he's going to be a part. We have a couple, I have a couple people giving testimonials. In fact, Anthony, did you do a podcast with Anthony?
I did.
Yep. Anthony's going to be there again. He spoke at my other, conference too. We've become good friends.
That's awesome. No, I mean, his story is incredible too. I mean, that's just amazing that you have such a strong community there. Plus the one you're building to add on to that. So that's awesome.
Yeah. It's amazing. Like I said, I'm one, I just reach out to anybody, especially if they're like in New Jersey. I reached out to this one girl who's close and now we've become close and we're doing a vegan cookie exchange in a couple weeks. There's like 10 of us.
Awesome.
So yeah, so it's just, and I just reached out to another cardiologist fellow in Pennsylvania. I've been talking with her. She wants to put something together in April. I told her I'd help her with it. So it's just so exciting to see because I just get chills every time I meet somebody else who says they're plant-based or they had such a miraculous story.
Right. You know? And you know, Karen, you were talking about how, you know, obviously not within, you know, the hospital where where you're a nurse, but like you also do health coaching through your website. So do you want to kind of talk about what you're doing with your site, as far as the blog and the health coaching and how all of that works?
Yeah. So I do one-on-one health coaching. Mostly they either come here to my house or I go to their house. So it's all local. I mean, I will do some, you know, remote too, but most of mine's one-on-one. I like to do the personal aspect of it. So most people find me either through Facebook or through my website or really word of mouth. It's usually somebody else I've worked with, a friend of theirs or something. So I'll go to their house. I'll do some coaching. We'll usually cook. I'll make a couple of dishes. I usually recommend that they buy the Instant Pot If you don't have one, I could be a spokesperson for it. I have had so many people buy the Instant Pot and love it.
Really? I'll admit, I actually don't have one.
Oh my God. Oh my God. But put it on your Santa list.
Fine. I'll write it down to you.
Oh my God.
You can follow me until I get one. Now I know a lot of my friends have it and will post it on Facebook and stuff. And we just haven't done it and I don't know why. So we'll do it just for you.
And it's like, and I did too. I resisted because I was in all these Facebook groups and they all raved about the Instant Pot. I'm like, oh my God, I already got, I have the Vitamix, I have the juicer, I got all this stuff. Do I need another appliance? And then on Prime Day, it was like a year and a half ago, it was like $69. They sold 250,000 of them in one day. It's crazy. So, and there's no turning back because the thing is freaking amazing. I mean, like I said, everybody that has bought it is now obsessed with it.
That's awesome. No, I'm excited. I'll check them out now.
Yes. So, because most people are busy, they want fast, they want easy. Everything that I cook is very easy. Like if I pull up a recipe and it has, a million ingredients, I like to go right to the next one. Mm-hmm. My problem is I'm Italian, so I tend to not measure things when I cook. I try to just grab and throw things in. Like tonight I just made a stew out of what I had. I had potatoes and beans and tomatoes and broth and tomato sauce. And it turned out absolutely delicious. My husband ate four bowls of it. It was so good. And it was just, those are like my best meals when I don't use a recipe.
Right.
But people are like, Karen, you need to write a book. I'm like, but I need someone to come over and help me because I don't measure anything. So when I cook with people, I just show them how easy it is to just throw things together. I mean, don't be afraid. Like people are so intimidated by cooking, I don't get it because it just comes so naturally to me. Mm-hmm. But when people see me do it and they do it with me, they get more comfortable. So right. That's why
it makes it more doable and like real.
Right.
Yeah.
Right. So that's why I like to go to their house and cook with them and see what the equipment they have. And, and like I said, I just shopped for a friend and I went to Trader Joe's and got a bunch of stuff for her. And, it's just, it's fun. It's exciting to help my friends. I mean, that's, and then, like I said, the ripple effect happens. And then I also do classes, cooking classes. So I'll go to people's house and do like a class for like 10 people. That way. I'm really, my goal is, in fact, I just started looking at some properties. I really would love to open up a cooking, a kitchen.
That'd be awesome.
A teaching kitchen, cause the name of my business is Karen's Healing Kitchen. So I would love to have that open and then I can partner with more doctors. And, when you go to the doctor and they say, you got to lose weight, you got to eat better. Mm-hmm. So they can say, well, listen, Karen has this kitchen. You can go learn how to cook healthy food. She's a nurse. She's going to show you, tell you how to help you to reverse your diabetes or your hypertension or whatever.
Yeah. No. You definitely should though, because that would be, that'd be amazing.
Yeah. That's my goal. And I had the perfect spot where the town I was looking at. It's like it's an up and coming town. It's got like a downtown area you walk, but the space was just too small. Like I couldn't fit. I could put a small one in there, but I won't make any money. I do have to make some money. Right. I give so much away. I mean, I help people text me every day, message me, and I just give, I give my information away because I just want to help people. So,
well, it'll come back to you. I mean, if you help people like that, the same thing with, nothing bad's going to happen from helping people. And then it all comes back around. So, it's such a rewarding feeling whenever you can help impact somebody like that in a positive way.
It is. And it's like, and people say, well, I don't want to bother you. I'm like, no, please bother me because I like to hear, I like to hear, success stories.
Yeah.
So, and that's, I have one of the girls I reached out on Facebook. She's also a fellow nurse and she's plant-based. And we have a condo down in Atlantic City. In New Jersey on the shore. And she lives down there. And I said, hey, you want to meet up for lunch? And we met up for lunch and it was like, she's young. Mm-hmm. So I'm like, anytime I come in contact with a young person, I like, it just makes my heart smile because I'm like, you're not going to suffer like I did, you know, for all these years. You know, you're going to be healthy. You know, you're going to raise your kids healthy. You know, I have a lot of regret because, you know, I obviously didn't know back then, but my girls, I couldn't breastfeed. So my girls were on formula. And after a few days, I switched my daughter Jessica to soy because she was projectile vomiting. So I switched her to the soy. But, you know, I don't know why I just didn't put them both on the soy. It made my, you know, I had like two different formulas and I would label their bottles so I wouldn't get them mixed up. And so Melissa was on a regular cow's milk formula. And I always remember now, I mean, first of all, she just cried all the time. And I still cringe all the time thinking of it. I mean, just 24/7, she cried. She never slept. We just said she was miserable. And the doctor just said, oh, you got a colicky baby. But she never threw up or anything. So we never switched her formula. But I know, you know, I remember now she was really constipated. And she also got sick a lot. She had ear infections. You know, she would get respiratory infections. Whereas Jessica never got sick. Jessica slept through the night. She was the happiest baby ever. And now I know it's because, you know, she was on soy for a whole year, whereas Melissa was on the cow's milk formula. And I know that messed her up. Mm-hmm. And I said, they could be a case history because Jessica was she did everything first. She walked first. She talked first. But she also was the kind of kid at the age of two, she could sit in front of the, I don't know how your daughter is, but she probably is good because she's eating good. But she could sit in front of a TV and watch a program, you know, a movie for like the whole thing in 2 hours.
Oh, yeah.
as a two-year-old and not move. Whereas Melissa could never, ever, ever sit still. And she was diagnosed, I diagnosed her with a little bit of ADD, but I dealt with it. I never got her, you know, labeled or anything. Mm-hmm. But she struggled more in school. Jessica was like a straight A bright student. She graduated first in her class through, you know, at high school. Melissa was always like agitated and, you know, just the signs of leaky gut. And I know it's from the cow's milk. And just that first year of life, they say, even though Jessica did drink milk, but I think, you know, we're learning more and more about the microbiome and the microbiome of newborns. And, mm-hmm. you know, I believe that her microbiome got completely messed up by the formula.
No, absolutely. I mean, the negative effects from having like leaky gut, I mean, just it's like you're talking about the behavioral differences. Mm-hmm. I mean, it has such a huge impact. And we're learning so much, but there's so much more to learn. It's super interesting. Definitely. Yeah.
And I even notice now as an adult, like she doesn't seem as agitated as she used to be. Like she seems calmer and she's not as fidgety. She used to be very, very fidgety. Mm-hmm. And I don't see that in her as much anymore since she's become vegan. So, and she's doing so great now. It's so amazing to see. I mean, because she's on her way home from Chicago, she's a director of ad operations for an advertising company. So
nice. That's awesome.
Yeah. I mean, they're both doing great. I mean, my other daughter's works for Vera Wang New York. Yeah. She's a director of sales for her. So, they're both doing great. And like I said, now that they're both, pretty much plant-based, I mean, they will occasionally eat like a piece of cake or a donut or a cookie if it's not vegan, but they're very much more conscious now. And, like I said, that makes me more happy than my husband being vegan.
No, for sure. No, that's all of that is amazing, Karen. And so I mean, like, what's do you have anything coming up in the future besides that kitchen that I know is going to happen? Just anything that you want to share with people, or just putting out more great content?
Yeah, well, like I said, I don't put out a blog. I'm very active on Instagram. I do the Instagram stories, and I'm very excited to see that they just put a new feature on Instagram where you can actually save your stories and put them in there's like a little, I guess, on your page so people can pull them up, which is great because, that's because I do the stories when I'm like, I did it for making dinner tonight. So I can show people what I did and now they're saved. So that's really cool. So I do that. And I have a Facebook page, the same thing. I'm most active on Instagram. I don't really, like I said, I don't really blog. I would say my Instagram is my blog. And I have, like I said, the conference that I'm working on in January, and I'm working on, you know, getting some more classes together for prenatal. We're trying to hit my prenatal population now too. just a lot. I have a lot that I want to do. I'm still working labor and delivery. So I still have to work there too.
Just to get some solid income. Right. I love it. And you were talking about your Instagram and your Facebook. What are your username? That way they can find you. I'm going to put everything into the show notes.
It's Karen's Healing Kitchen.
Awesome. For both of them?
Yes.
Awesome. And then your website is just karenshealingkitchen.com, right?
Yes. Yes. On my resource page and my, there's a lot of just links on there. In fact, I'm going to add yours on there too now. Your podcast.
Awesome. No, I appreciate that. That's awesome. Yeah. Karen, and then this closing question that I ask every guest, but if you just had one piece of advice for the audience, maybe it was something that was your biggest takeaway through your whole wellness journey. But if you just had one piece of advice to give, what would it be?
My advice is to love yourself enough to take care of yourself. And I found that until I loved myself, I learned to love myself. I really started to really take care of myself. And that's not just, you know, what you eat. It's everything, your mind, you know, your relationships, everything. Just reevaluate everything, but start with loving yourself first.
Awesome. No, that's perfect, Karen. And Karen, thank you so much for taking time to come on. I loved having you. I'm glad we finally got to connect. And I'm excited just to watch all of the amazing work that you do.
Oh, thank you so much. This was awesome. And I hope maybe someday we'll meet.
No, absolutely. We will.
All right.
Awesome. Thanks, Karen.
All right. Great. Have a great night.
Thank you guys so much for tuning into today's episode. I hope you loved my conversation with Karen. Her story is just so inspiring, and I love all of the work she's doing. So I'm excited for you guys to get to follow her on social media to keep up with everything that she's doing. You can find the social media links that we talked about in the episode in the show notes, but you can also find them on my website as well at drkaseyjohnson.com. That's drkaseyjohnson.com. Click on the Listen tab. Then from there, you'll be able to see all of the past guests that have come on the Unlock Wellness podcast, read a little bit about each guest, and be able to click on their social media links, website, all of that. So all of Karen's information can be found on my site as well. If you guys love today's episode with Karen, be sure to jump onto iTunes, subscribe, and write a review. It really helps me out a lot, and I really appreciate all of the feedback and support. And like I spoke about in the intro, also be sure to check out my first children's book of my healthy children's book series called Maddox's Trip to the Chiropractor. Each purchase of the book supports the Unlock Wellness Project, which applies a wellness bag to a child in need for each book purchased. You can learn more about the book and the Unlock Wellness Project on my website as well at drkaseyjohnson.com. Click on the Shop tab, then choose the children's book option. You'll be able to read a short description and even watch a short video to learn more. If you do purchase the book, be sure to share it on social media using the hashtag UWProject. I'll repost it and give you a shout out on the podcast. But I hope you guys loved the book. Thank you so much for the support. And I hope you loved today's episode. Thank you guys so much for tuning in.